For the separation of isotopes, special separation plants were built. One of them, for instance, is located in Oak Ridge, in the US. In terms of its scale, it reminds us of our synchrophasotron here in Dubna. The synchrophasotron is an enormous facility, which isn't much different from an accelerator of those days. Regarding the use of a linear accelerator as an instrument in plutonium production, the work on it was commenced by a famous American physicist, Louis Alvarez. Near the Berkeley laboratory where he used to work, there was a runway for the US Navy in the city of Livermore. At that time, it wasn't being used, so it was decided to use the 500 meters of concrete runway for the construction of a linear accelerator, which would need to satisfy the required parameters, that is, an energy level of 100 mega electron volts with a 1 ampere proton beam current. The first section of this accelerator was completed. It was an iron tank 17 meters in diameter and 18 meters in length. A truck drove inside the tank with a 2-ton drift tube. These drift tubes were placed on special devices and attached to the top of a resonator. After that, high-frequency power was put into the resonator, and it was supposed to ensure proton beam acceleration at the required level of energy. Unfortunately, or maybe fortunately, this project never reached its project goals. Furthermore, the first section couldn't be fed with the high frequency power required for the acceleration because of permanent breakdowns, which could not be overcome. Today, only photographs are left of this project, and the accelerator was demolished for scrap. The subsequent efforts didn't lead to a considerable success in this area. However, they resulted in the creation of many types of modern linear proton accelerators.